today we want to be every single Pokemon champion, and there is a lot of them now, as Silver. Silver has access to some incredibly powerful Pokemon like Ursaring and Feraligatr, but would he be able to take on and defeat every Pokemon champion? If he does manage to beat them all, there's three powerful trainers he must face to claim victory. If a Pokemon faints, it's gone from the whole run, and a few more rules to add on for more difficulty. Can Silver beat every Pokemon champion? First up is Pokemon Fire Red, and we've got the champion for this game, Blue. Honestly, our team is great, but we have some major weaknesses. A Feraligatr's strength could be what we need to get through the first few games. Blue's lead is his Pidgeot, and we lead off with Feraligatr, who matches up super well versus Blue's team. Turn 1, we freeze our fist and deliver an Ice Punch to bring the bird low. Then he retaliates with a Sand Attack, lowering our accuracy. Blue 4 restores the bird as we keep on Ice Punching, and we take him out of a critical hit. This brings out Exeggutor, but there's no reason to swap, as our Ice Punch is doing over half, and he just sets up a light screen. Then he puts us to sleep, and Giga Drains us for big damage, so now we do have to switch. I go into Murkrow on the Giga Drain, and we take it nicely. We fly in the air and take down the three-headed Eggplant. Thanks to our pretty weak attack stat, he survives, as he misses an attack. We then get to take him out with a Wing Attack. Out next comes Rhydon, and we have an easy swap to Gyarados that's shiny and looks fantastic, as he misses a Rock-Tomb. We then Hydro Pump Rhydon for a one-hit knockout. This brings out his Alakazam next. I go for a Hyper Beam, every kid's favourite move to use, and we take out Alakazam in just one attack too. This brings out Arcanine, who goes for an Extreme Speed on the turn we recharge. We get hit again from an Extreme Speed before hitting a Hydro Pump on the Fire-type to bring into a sliver of HP. Blue now 4 restores again as our next Hydro Pump critical hits to take him down, leaving just a Blastoise left. I go for a Hyper Beam, doing massive damage to a sliver of HP as he heals with his berry and brings Gyarados low too. Blue 4 restores, and we've got to switch, so I go into Kingdra. We can't really hurt Blastoise at all, to be honest, so it becomes an exchange of Rain Boosted Waterfalls and Bites and Hydro Pumps, as Blue just keeps full restoring. Eventually, we have to swap, so I go into Ursaring, who takes a Hydro Pump to very low, and he delivers a critical hit slash to win the fight. Not very convincingly, I must say. That's the first champion down. It's time to take on Johto's champion. Lance is a champion of Johto, and the next we face, he's a flying a dragon type champion. We can have our evolved Murkrow and Sneasel now, but I'm not sure how they will impact this fight, so let's give it a shot. Lance's lead is Gyarados, and we lead off with Feraligatr. I immediately swap into Gyarados as he dragon pulses us. We then go for a Hyper Beam for actually negative damage as he keeps dragon pulsing us. So I swap back to Feraligatr as he dragon pulses us, and we take him down with returns. His first dragon comes out and falls to a single Ice Punch from our monster Feraligatr. Then out comes his second Dragonite, who suffers the same fate. This brings out Aerodactyl, who goes for a Thunder Fang, bringing us low as an Ice Punch barely misses out on the knockout. I swap to Kingdra as Lance 4 restores, and then we get Rock Slide flinched. We get Rock Slided again, bringing us low before a Waterfall brings him down. This brings in his biggest threat, the level 50 Dragonite. I swap to Gyarados to get off the Intimidate on Dragonite as an Outrage brings us low. I then swap to Honchkrow, who takes the next Outrage, but awfully as he gets confused. And on our swap again to Ursaring, he connects another. I have to now risk a death here already, and thankfully Dragonite hits himself in confusion as our Avalanche brings him to 1 HP. He then eats his berry, but we are still in big trouble. Dragonite breaks through, outrages us to 3 HP as we connect an Avalanche to take him down. His last Pokemon is Charizard. I have no switch-ins whatsoever, my team is decimated. We swap to Weavile as we live a Dragon Claw. We then Blizzard for not much damage, and a Fire Fang brings us very low. I swap to Kingdra on a Fire Fang, which we thankfully survive, and then we finish off Charizard, beating Lance deathless, but this is very, very rough already. On to Hoenn's champions next. In Pokemon Ruby, Steven is a champion. He's got mainly Rock and Steel types. We match up quite nicely versus him, but back to a Murkrow and Sneasel for now too. We can only use them scarcely as they're so frail and we need them to survive. Steven's lead is Skarmory, and Feraligatr starts using Surf as he sets up a layer of spikes. We Surf once more to take down the Steel Bird. Second out is Aggron, who's got low special defense and is weak to water, so falls to a single Surf too. Then Steven sends out Cradilly. We Ice Punch for a good amount of damage as he Giga Drains us for a nice chunk too, and heals himself in the process. We Ice Punch him again, and we put him in the red, and we freeze him. Steven now full restores, so we just keep on Ice Punching until the Ancient Grass Pokemon eventually falls. Fourth out is Claydol. A surf run for Alligator just decimates him. This brings out his ace, Metagross. We surf for over half as he goes for a psychic, putting us on a sliver of HP as he heals with his berry. A final surf, and we take him down. This just leaves an Armaldo left. We're in torrent range, boosting our water type attack, so a final surf, and for Alligator, sweep Steven Stone. Fantastic. Onto something that may now be rougher. Our second champion for Generation 3 is Wallace. He's a water type specialist with some powerful Pokemon. This could be rough for our team. We have zero super effective moves on him. Let's try and take him down. Wallace leads with a massive Wailord, and turn one our return isn't doing too much as he sets up the rain boosting water type moves. We return again and put him lower as he double edges and puts himself lower too. I then return once more to put him on a sliver of HP as he hits us with a double edge and falls to his own recoil. Out comes Ludicolo, and as we switch into Ursaring he sets up a double team. He then sets up another double team, but we connect our slash to bring him low. Rain ends and we connect another slash to take him out, luckily. Tentacruel then takes a massive slash. He then poisons us, activating our ability Guts, boosting our attack. So then we take him down. This brings out Whiscash. We slash to put him in the red as he goes for an amnesia. Wallace then tries to stall us by full restoring several times while we're dying to toxic. So in the end, we have to switch, and I go into Kingdra on the full restore. I then start hitting very weak waterfalls as he earthquakes us. I need to swap again, so I go into Murkrow on the incoming earthquake. We then hit a fly to bring him low before we take a hyper beam, but not well at all. A final fly in the air, and Whiscash falls. Now is his ace Milotic. We need to switch and we're running out of options. I go into Feraligatr on the ice beam and we get frozen, not good. But we then four out and hit a critical hit return as a surf brings us extremely low. We then swap to Gyarados and we take a surf very well. We then start hyper beaming and we take down Milotic. This brings out Gyarados. We swap into Sneasel and take the surf. Then we swap back to Gyarados to get off the intimidate, lowering his attack as he dragon dances, and we hyper beam to bring him to below half. We take a hyper beam ourselves, putting us on a sliver of HP before our hyper beam can take him down, beating Wallace in a very tricky battle. It's time to upgrade our team and move on to the Gen 4 champion. Cynthia is a champion of the Sinnoh region. Her team is a powerful one. We can now fully evolve our Pokemon and we have a solid team to work with. So far these battles have been really tough, so let's see if my team can pull through here. Cynthia's lead is Spirit Tomb, and well, we lead with Feraligatr as always. We hit an Aqua Tail for great damage, just critical hitting the ghost type turn 1. Then comes Roserade and we deliver a freezing ice punch for a one hit knockout too. Third is Togekiss and another Ice Punch, and we snag a freeze. What RNG. A final Ice Punch for Alligator is just beat half of her team in seconds. Then is Garchomp. He actually lives an Ice Punch and hits an Earthquake, bringing us to half before we take him down with another Ice Punch. This brings out Lucario, who lives an Aqua Tail and nearly kills us with an Aura Sphere. That was close. I decide to not risk anything more and swap to Gyarados as Cynthia goes for a full restore. We then hit a Fire Blast, bringing him low before we take a weak Psychic. A final Fire Blast and down he goes, leaving only a Milotic left. I go for a Hyper Beam, but it does nothing before a Miracoat nearly kills us. Milotic then sets up an Aqua Ring on the turn we recharge him, so I swap to Ursa Ring, who tanks an Ice Beam. We then slash for great damage as Milotic surfs, putting us lower. It's a risky play, but I decide to slash again as it pays off, and we take down Milotic, beating Cynthia with not many issues, although we were close to losing for Alligator. It's time to head to Unova, where two champions await us. First up in Gen 5 is Alder, and he's got some solid Pokemon with a glaring weakness to fire with a few bugs on his team. Let's start Unova. Alder's lead of Veselgor isn't the best for our Water Star, as an Energy Ball really hurts us before a single critical hit Aqua Tail takes him out. How many turn 1 crits have I got? This is insane. This brings out a Scavalier, and it's an instant swap to Gyarados to intimidate him as he goes for a Giga Impact. We then hit a 4x super effective Fire Blast to melt the Steel Bug. Third is Bouffalon, and it's an issue. I swap to Kingdra on the Stone Edge, and we take it nicely. We then go for a Waterfall, which critical hits as a Head Charge puts us on 8 HP. Alder will now full restore, so I go for a Waterfall again. Not risking losing Kingdra here, I need to swap, so I go into Ursaring as we dodge a Head Charge. We then get to take him down with a Slash. This brings out his Dragon Druddigon. We get hit from a Payback, which does barely nothing when he could have gone for a Superpower before our Avalanche destroys him. This brings out Volcarona. We swap straight into Gyarados on the Overheat that really doesn't do too much damage to us. We then deliver a Hydro Pump to the face to bring the Bug Glory as it sets up a Quiver Dance. This is not good. I then swap to Honchkrow as it goes for a Hyper Beam, bringing us to half HP. We then fly in the air the turn it's recharging, and we take down this big threat. Out next is Vanilluxe, as Alder's last Pokemon. I go straight into Weavile on the incoming Blizzard, which still does a quarter to us. We then Rock Smash for good damage as he sets up a Light Screen. We Rock Smash once more as he then goes for an Acid Armor, raising his defense. We Rock Smash again to put him in the red as he hits a Flash Cannon to put us on 24 HP. Thankfully, Alder doesn't decide to heal here, and we take down the ice cream with a final attack, beating Alder. But there's still one more champion in Generation 5 to face. Iris is the second champion, and the majority of her Pokemon are dragons. For Alligator, could destroy Iris, as her team is weak to him. However, Lapras with Thunderbolt is a problem too. Iris's lead is Hydreigon, and in a rare change for once, we can outspeed and do massive damage with an Ice Punch from our MVP of the run so far, before we take a Dragon Pulse to nearly half. A final Ice Punch, and down he goes. Second is the problem though, Lapras. I bite it, and we take a Thunderbolt to put us in the red. I now switch into Ursa Ring, and we take the Thunderbolt, but we don't get paralyzed for guts. We then slash for massive damage, and an Ice Beam doesn't do too much to us. A final slash, and Lapras falls next. Third is Druddigon. I don't want to risk Ursa Ring here, so I swap into Gyarados as we take a Focus Blast. Then we twist her for basically nothing before nearly dying to a Rock Slide. I now swap into Honchkrow as we take the Rock Slide, but we take it even worse, so we have to swap yet again into Kingdra on the next Rock Slide. We then twist her again, doing great damage, and we get a flinch. Another twister puts him on a sliver as he Focus Blasts us. Iris then goes for a full restore, but we twist her again. I stay in and go for a yet another twister before we take our first death of the run in Kingdra, fall into Druddigon. This now gives me a free swap to Weavile though, and here we Icy Wind to take revenge for our fallen Pokemon, and she sends out her ace Haxorus next. I Icy Wind again to lower his speed as he does in fact go for a Dragon Dance. The next turn, Weavile can hit a Blizzard, destroying her ace Haxorus and taking him out. Out next is Archeops, but it's weak to Ice and a Blizzard just absolutely destroys him too. This just leaves an Aggron left. We just keep Rock Smashing as the only move he ever clicks is Automize as we bring him low. Then he decides to switch it up by going for a Double Edge, putting us on only 7 HP before we take him down. This means we beat Iris, but we suffer our first death of the run. It's time to head on to Generation 6 and Kalos. Dianthra is the champion of Kalos and who we take on next. Her team's really strong and she does have a Mega Gardevoir for her. We've subbed in a Tyranitar, and thanks to a Master ZX promo, he's shiny and we're gonna Mega Evolve him because why not? I decide to give him some time in the limelight by leading with our shiny Tyranitar, and well, we Mega Evolve straight away against the Luchador Bird as he hits a super effective Flying Press for a good chunk of damage, but a Stone Edge critical hit takes him down. Another turn 1 critical hit. Second out comes Gudra, the bulky dragon, but even he can't stand to the might of our Mega and falls to a Stone Edge too. Third is the T-Rex Tyrantrum. I go for a Stone Edge when I probably should have gone for an Earthquake as a Head Smash does a good amount to us and puts a T-Rex in full restore range. So the next turn, Dianthra does burn a full restore as I go for an Earthquake this time to take down the T-Rex. This brings out Galgeist and I actually need to swap, so I go into Honchkrow on the Seed Bomb. We then fly high up in the sky to dodge an attack and land on the plant's head to obliterate it. Out next is Aurorus, the Ice Dinosaur, and I swap to Gyarados to intimidate it on the Blizzard, which does a little bit of damage to us. I then stay in and go for a Hydro Pump, not taking it out, and luckily dodge a Thunder. I forgot this thing even had Thunder. That would have definitely killed Gyarados. We got very lucky. A final Hydro Pump, and down he goes. This just leaves us with one Pokemon left to face, and that's her ace Gardevoir. She Mega Evolves as we swap into Ursa Ring, and we take the Thunderbolt. But there's no way we can live a Moonblast, so I swap back into Gyarados, who takes a Moonblast better. This means we can now bait out a Thunderbolt, giving us a swap into Tyranitar, who sets up the sand, and this should mean we can tank the Thunderbolt, which we do. We thankfully the next turn outspeed and connect to Stone Edge and win the Mega Standoff, taking down Gardevoir, beating Dianthra, and become champion of Kalos. It's time to take on Alola next. How is the person we fight to become champion here in Alola, and he's always one of the most trickiest. His team really does pack a punch. I think we can deal with him, but Deathless is going to be really hard. Let's do it. Howl's lead is an Alolan Raichu, and Feraligatr is in trouble turn 1. I think we can tank a Thunderbolt, and we do. Then we deliver a bite to Raichu to bring him down low. Howl full restores him up now, and we're in Torrent range, so an Aqua Tail takes him down. This just brings out Leafeon though, so we've got to swap, so into Weavile I go, and the Leaf Blade still nearly takes us down. I then proceed to Blizzard Leafeon and pick up the knockout. This then brings out Incineroar, and only one thing is coming, his Z move. We have a pretty good answer in our Gyarados, who can intimidate him, lowering his attack as Incineroar does in fact go for Inferno Overdrive. He drops a nuke on Gyarados' head, but we tank it quite nicely to close to half, and it's good having an answer to this, or a death was for sure about to happen. We then Hydro Pump Incineroar, doing just about half to the bulky fire type as he goes for a Darkest Lariat, putting Gyarados low. A final Hydro Pump, and that's another huge threat taken care of. This now brings out Crabominable, and we really don't have a switch into an Ice Hammer. We go into Tyranitar and we take way over half from it. I'm really out of options here and ideas, so I swap to Honchkrow, just praying we can survive one hit, but Crabominable for some reason power up punches, which is best case scenario, but it still does nearly half to us. But now we survive, we can fly up in the air, dodging attack, and we both take chip damage before we get the knockout with a fly. Now is another huge issue though, Tauros. Our team is getting weaker and weaker, with only an Ursaring at full HP left, but he's not bulky, so we need to swap a lot. I go into Ursaring and he double edges us, doing massive damage, but taking a good chunk of recoil too. The sand falls and we need it to start whittling away, so we swap back into Tyranitar to set up the sand once more, and we live a double edge on 40 HP as we keep chipping away at him. I now go into Honchkrow for the sacrifice. I genuinely don't have a choice at this point, and Honchkrow falls, as Tauros then takes recoil and sand damage too. Our only Pokemon now faster than this thing is Weavile. Blizzard could miss, Rock Smash won't do enough, and this is where I decide, with nothing to lose, to Beat Up. Beat Up is a unique move where everyone in our party gets to attack him. The fourth hit of this move does just enough damage to take down the bull, leaving us with Anuivan left to fight. Thankfully, we are faster, and a four times super effective Blizzard takes him down, beating Hal. But our team just got demolished, and we lost our second Pokemon, Honchkrow. RIP Bird. It's time to move on to the Switch games. So, for Trace, we don't have a full team of Pokemon. In fact, only one. That's Gyarados. So like last video, I'm going to max his AVs and turn him into a literal god. If he falls, we lose the challenge. Let's do this. We lead with our god Gyarados, and while Trace Mega Evolves his Pidgeot, I decide to Hydro Pump, and the animation looks so strong, it's no wonder we take down Pidgeot in one attack. Second is Jolteon. I go for a Hydro Pump, but we just miss out on the knockout as he misses a Thunder. Trace starts using a plethora of full restores now, but eventually he stops, and we Dragon Rage to take him down. This brings out Vileplume. I just go for a Hyper Beam, expecting to take it down, but it survives and sets up a Reflect Boost in the team's defense. We recharge as Vileplume then hits us with a Sludge Bomb. The next turn, we take him down with a Fire Blast. On Slowbro, I just go for Hyper Beams. We hit him twice to nuke the bulky water type, and he falls too. Then is the Fire Horse Rapidash. It can't live to the mighty water attack from our godly Gyarados, and he falls. Marowak is his last Pokemon, and we're out of Hydro Pump PP, so I Hyper Beam, and Marowak survives too, but hits a weak Brick Break. A few more full restores from Trace, and Gyarados just keep on attacking, but it's a losing battle, and eventually Gyarados gets to take down Marowak, sweeping Trace. This means we move on to our next champion, Sword and Shield. The champion for Sword and Shield is Leon. His team is really strong with a Gigantamax Charizard. We can't use Fralligator or Ursaring here, so I've substituted in Entei, who he had for a short period of time, and a Rhyperia that Blue traded him for a brief period too. This still puts us at only 5 Pokemon to take on Leon. We can't afford any more deaths now going into the final push. Let's do it. Leon's lead is his Aegislash, and I lead with the mighty Entei, which gives us an immediate advantage. We actually miss our Fire Blast, meaning we get blasted with a Shadow Ball that does a real high amount of damage to us and lowers our special defense. The next turn, we hit a Fire Blast, this time for a one-hit knockout, taking him down. But this just brings out Haxorus. Honestly, my switch-ins are so limited. Entei is here to do as much damage as he can, and he does that with an extra sensory, bringing Haxorus to nearly half, before an Earthquake takes down our legendary Pokemon, putting us now at 3 deaths. But he's done his job well, he's leveled the playing field for us. Weavile is my best shout here, as a super effective Blizzard ends Leon's first Dragon. This brings out his second Dragon, and Dragapult. We connect another Blizzard, and that's just too cold for the Ghost Dragon to survive. Out next is Mr. Rhyme, the Dancing Mr. Mime, and it's a perfect opportunity to beat him up as we go for a Beat Up, and it does a solid amount of damage, and thanks to one of them critical hitting, Weavile takes down Mr. Rhyme with no issues, really putting in some work here. Then out comes Inteleon. We go for a Beat Up again, and we manage to do over half with 4 hits, as he goes for a Mudshot, lowering our accuracy too in the process. The next turn, Inteleon goes for a Tearful Look, reducing our attack stat as well, but thanks to another one of the 4 turn Beat Ups critical hitting, we take down Inteleon. This gives us a last Pokemon to face, but it's a strong one, Charizard. Leon Gigantamaxes his Charizard, and I instantly swap into Tyranitar as he goes for a Max Rockfall, which we take decently. Charizard then takes a little bit of chip damage as well from Sandstorm. He then, the next turn, goes for a Max Overgrowth, which is super effective against Tyranitar, but our bulk and sand means we take it like a champ, and we reconnect to Stone Edge to just decimate his Gigantamax Charizard, beating Leon and leaving one champion left to face in our conquest. The last champion is Geeta for Generation 9, and she's got some really unique Pokemon too. We now have back Ursa and Gamferaligatr. Can we defeat Geeta? Let's find out. Her leader's a Sparfer, and Feraligatr looks like a monster in this generation. I love it. We bite the Psychic Ostrich for good damage turn 1 as the Sparfer replies with a Lumina Crash that we take decently. A final bite from our fangs and we take down her first Pokemon. On Golgol, I go into Ursa Ring. Golgol bulks up, raising his attack and defense as our Avalanche doesn't do too much. He then Horn Leeches us the next turn for good damage and healing him in the process, but our next Avalanche rolls higher and we take down the Golt. Third is Avalug and I go into Gyarados. It's got great defense, but on the special side, not so great, as it can't stand the heat and falls to a single Fire Blast. On King Gambit, we go into Rhyperia. A single Earthquake from our Rhyperia, and he shows his worth instantly by taking him down in just one attack. Next is Veluza, and I go back into Feraligatr. We bite the fish for half of his HP, and we take a Psycho Cut. A final bite from our alligator's jaws, and down he goes, leaving one Pokemon left standing in our way, Glamora. We swap to Tyranitar, and Geeta terrestrializes into a pure Rock type. We then Earthquake to bring Glamora to a sliver of HP as we take an Earth Power, but we take it very, very well. This means a final Earthquake from Tyranitar, and we take down Glamora, beating Geeta and every single Pokemon champion as Silver. Or have we? Atop of the snowy Mount Silver is a legendary trainer Red and a champion trainer at that. Thankfully, Feraligatr immediately outspeeds Pikachu and takes him down with a return. This then brings out Venusaur, who we hit an Ice Punch on for good damage before he misses a Sleep Powder. A final Ice Punch and he falls too. Third is Blastoise. We hit a return for good damage and we dodge a Focus Blast. We return again, putting him lower before a Focus Blast brings us to half, and Hail means Red now for restores, as we just keep on returning. Eventually, we have to swap, so I go into Gyarados on the critical hit Focus Blast. We then swap to Tyranitar and luckily we dodge an attack. We then finish off Blastoise with an Earthquake. This now brings out Lapras. I stay in a Stone Edge and Tyranitar is just a monster and takes it out with one attack. Snorlax is his next Pokemon, but he can't handle a Stone Edge either and dies instantly, leaving only a Charizard left. But he's 4 times weak to Rock and he falls to a single Stone Edge too, beating Red as he disappears and we continue. Team Plasma N and the champion himself, who also has a legendary we need to win to continue. N leads with Reshiram and we lead with Feraligatr. We hit an Aqua Tail for good damage and we take a Fusion Flare in return. We hit another Aqua Tail before Reshiram hits us with a Hyper Beam, but we dodge it. N then full restores Reshiram, so we just keep on attacking him. We then take a Hyper Beam, putting us in Torrent range, so our final Aqua Tail takes down the legendary. This brings out Klinklang, so I swap into Rhyperior, who is immune to the Thunderbolt. We then take a Flash Cannon, destroying our HP before taking him down with an Earthquake. Third is Karacosta. I swap to Gyarados to intimidate him, as we then Hydro Pump for good damage, and we take a Stone Edge to put us really low. A final Hydro Pump, and down goes Karacosta. Out next is Archeops, and he's slower than us, and he falls to a single Hydro Pump from our shiny Gyarados 2. This brings out Vanilluxe. We swap into Ursa Ring as he blizzards us for good damage, as we then Fire Punch the Ice Cream Cone, and he sets up the Hail, healing him a little bit too. A final Fire Punch, and down goes Vanilluxe, leaving just a Zoroark left. He has Focus Blast, and he could probably just sweep my team. I swap to Gyarados on the Focus Blast, and luckily we dodge it. I then swap into Tyranitar on the Night Slash, and we dodge that too. Then Zoroark actually misses a Focus Blast, and a single Stone Edge from Tyranitar takes him down, beating N and moving on to the last champion. Kieran, the most latest champion to be introduced and one of the hardest. This has a focus on double battles. This battle, I've upgraded our moveset to have a better chance as it's a final battle, turning things like Bite into Crunch. Let's finish this. Kieran leads Politoed and Dragonite with an emphasis on a rain setup. We lead with Feraligatr and Ursa Ring. Turn 1, Feraligatr hits an Ice Punch on Dragonite for good damage, breaking multi-scale as Politoed hits a Weather Ball into Ursa Ring for massive damage, before Dragonite hits a Breaking Swipe on Feraligatr and Ursa Ring, lowering both their attack and leaving Ursa Ring on the brink of death, before Ursa Ring delivers an Avalanche which critical hits to take him down. Kieran now sends out Porygon Z, and this is bad. Porygon Z as he goes for a Hyper Beam to take down Ursa Ring? I mean, he was on 5 HP, I'll take that. RIP though, Bear, you did great. Feraligatr's Rain Boosted Aqua Tail now doesn't take down Porygon, as we take a pretty weak Weather Ball. We swap into Weavile and I go for an Ice Shard to definitely kill Porygon Z as I can't afford it to survive, and Feraligatr hits another Aqua Tail that does basically nothing to Politoed before a Weather Ball does massive damage to Weavile. Kieran now sends out Incineroar, who we weakens Fralligator's attack even more thanks to Intimidate, and this is not good. Weavile's for a knockoff on Politoed and knocks off his Wakan berry as Fralligator's Aqua Tail does a massive chunk to Incineroar as he eats his berry, healing him a little bit. Then Politoed goes for a Weather Ball, finishing off Weavile and killing him. R.I.P. Weavile. Fralligator then tanks Incineroar's Brick Break, surviving another turn. I now send out Gyarados to try and take advantage of the rain. Politoed goes for a helping hand on Incineroar as Gyarados' Aqua Tail takes him out in one attack. Fralligator's Aqua Tail then does negative damage to Politoed and the rain stops. Out next is Grimmsnarl. Gyarados hits an Iron Head for good damage and Fralligator misses an Aqua Tail. Politoed then goes for a Psychic to finally take down our starter, who's been our most impressive Pokemon this run. Rest easy, dude. Grimmsnarl's Spirit Break really hurts our Gyarados. We then send out Tyranitar and we set up the sand. Gyarados brings Grimmsnarl to a sliver of HP with an Iron Head, and Tyranitar's Earthquake takes him down and brings Politoed to a sliver too. But now his Weather Ball is a rock move, so it hits Gyarados super effectively and takes him low, and this is coming down to the wire. Grimmsnarl then falls to the Sandstorm damage, and now it's a 3-on-1. Kieran sends out his last Pokemon Hydrapple and Terastalizes it into a pure fighting type. Gyarados hits an Aqua Tail for good damage and Tyranitar misses a Stone Edge, that's bad. Hydrapple goes for a Fickle Beam, taking down Gyarados and putting us at 7 deaths. But we still have 2 Pokemon left, but they're both weak to fighting. We send out Rhyperior and Tyranitar misses yet another Stone Edge, and Rhyperior hits a Rock Wrecker. Hydrapple's Fickle Beam obliterates Tyranitar and I've just choked. Rock Wrecker means we are recharging now and Hydrapple goes for a Terror Blast, but Rhyperior holds on thanks to its bulk, and that was extremely close. With a final Earthquake, we can take down Hydrapple, beating Kieran and beating every single Pokemon champion as Silver. Wow. 8 deaths and 1 survived. That came really down to the wire there at the end. I really nearly choked the fight. This was a super fun run to do, and it was fun going back to doing deaths as well as attempts. If you like this video, make sure to leave a like, subscribe if you're new. As always, I appreciate you watching, and I'll see you in the next one.